The bushfire threat on Kangaroo Island has finally reduced tonight. Authorities now working to figure out exactly how many properties have been lost. But everyone thankful no more lives were lost in the horrific conditions that saw the strong winds pushing the flames towards the island's most populated areas.
These holiday homes stood little chance from a firestorm that was simply unstoppable.
It's an experience you wouldn't want to have to go through again.
Despite an evacuation order, Greg Follett remained in Vivon Bay yesterday to protect his home. He filmed as the first fire front raged dangerously close to the town before reaching the beach. But it was a second threat after dark that saw at least three homes destroyed.
To this massive plume of smoke and like 100-foot flames, and it came across pretty much all the way through to the beach here, but we thought all of these houses were going to go, but the bombers, the CFS bombers and that, did a brilliant job.
The Vivon Bay Lodge, owned by SeaLink, also lost. Authorities now sweeping the southern part of Kangaroo Island to determine the full extent of the damage.
We are doing the rapid assessment, but thankfully there was not the damage that was once thought could have happened through Vivon Bay.
It was one of two towns that authorities held serious concerns for. The other was Pandana, in the middle of the island, where flames tore through Conlon Tremaine's farm.
Very, very upset, and I don't know what to say. It's just a bloody mess.
But he's thankful his home was spared. So too the township, which came under extreme threat.
I mean, there was definitely stacked against us last night, but quite miraculous, really. I think the town's still here, to be quite frank.
The flames also stopping just short of the Kangaroo Island Wildlife Park.
We just had glowing all around us. We could see flames and we were ready.
Workers now continuing to treat the scores of injured animals being brought in.
You can actually see the singed fur on the side of his paw there.
This latest flare-up coming a week after two lives were lost and 56 homes destroyed. The mayor says the intense firefight and widespread devastation has left the community shattered.
Everything's gone. It's about as badly as possible and as well as can be expected. I mean, that sums up everything in this last 3 weeks. We've done our best, and the best hasn't been good enough, but we'll battle on.
The state has been remarkably lucky that more people haven't been killed and injured in what has been the worst season we've endured in living memory.
Tonight, a bushfire advice message remains in place for almost the entire island, from where we are here at Kingscote all the way through to the Flinders Chase. There are still plenty of hotspots burning throughout the fire zone, and the CFS is wary of flare-ups. The conditions are easing over here at the moment. However, the wind is still very strong, and crews are desperate to avoid a repeat of the devastation and danger we saw overnight.
This is what fire crews had to contend with. Flames being fanned by strong winds tearing across Kangaroo Island in the dark of the night. Wind changes pushing the flames towards Emu Bay, where residents were evacuated onto the beach. Kingscote was meant to be a safe place, but even it came under threat as the blaze gained momentum.
You don't really sleep. I mean, it's really quite scary.
Some bringing animals with them.
I think we've got 16 in Kingscote, but we've still got about 10 at home.
All facing an anxious wait.
Pretty horrendous, really, not much sleep. With the dogs in the car and everything, and just not knowing what we're going to go home to. So, yeah, it's been pretty tough, but it's been tough for everyone, so.
The flames race towards the Kingscote Airport, which is where firefighters and the army have been based, with some forced to evacuate. Those in charge say the strong winds and multiple breakouts make containing the blaze impossible.
When we have five or six across the whole island, it is just more than what we can reasonably deal with, particularly when it's in vegetation and the fire intensity is way in excess of what our aircraft and our ground crews can actually suppress.
The threat had finally reduced mid-morning, 250 firefighters on the ground working tirelessly to prevent any further flare-ups.
They're all exhausted today and we've got to keep going. We can't afford to stop now that the weather has eased off.
What's now making this fight easier is this rain. It's been coming down since this morning. It won't put out the fire, but every drop helps. And while the immediate threat may have passed, crews know the danger is far from over, with the fire expected to burn for weeks.
We've got a limited window before the next hot day. Our priority task is to get back in and build those control lines again.
Harvey Biggs, Nine News.